Hey, how's it going? Question for you. Have you ever been intrigued by the idea of learning character animation, but you felt overwhelmed by its complexity? Well, this video is for you then, because it's going to be an introduction to character animation in After Effects. I'm gonna walk you through what it is and how to get started, and hopefully by the end of this video, you'll begin to see that character animation isn't quite so intimidating when you break it down into smaller, more digestible pieces. But first, we need to consider this question. Why should you learn character animation in the first place? Well, if you're like me, you may find it easier to express or convey ideas through characters rather than abstract graphics and symbols. Characters are a powerful tool for connecting with your audience or your customers, whether that's creating a short film or an explainer video. Secondly, clients love character animations. They're drawn to them. So offering this service can help them, your clients, fall in love with your work, which can lead to repeat business, of course, and referrals, potentially broadening your clientele and fostering long-term relationships with your clients. Lastly, if you don't consider yourself good at drawing, traditional frame-by-frame animation may seem out of reach for you. However, learning to animate characters in After Effects offers an alternative route to tap into the world of creative storytelling through character animation, even without extensive drawing abilities or no drawing abilities at all. The most fundamental element of a character animation in After Effects is the character rig. In this video, we're going to concentrate on character rigs, discussing what they are, how they function, their various components, and finally, a brief introduction to the tools available out there for creating character rigs in After Effects. So let's start with the first question. What is a character rig? Well, I went ahead and asked ChatGPT for a definition of a character rig, and this is the answer it gave me, and I think it's spot on. A character rig is a structured or organized system of interconnected elements such as bones, joints, and controls that is used to manipulate and animate a character in 2D or 3D animation software. The rig is essentially serves as a digital puppet, providing animators with an efficient and flexible way to control the character's movements, facial expressions, and other aspects of its performance. What are these interconnected elements that make up a character rig in After Effects? At its most essential, it is broken into two categories: the character artwork and the controllers that you use to control the movement of your characters. These control layers are like the little wooden cross used by puppeteers to control the puppet. The core of a character, the hips to the head, is nothing special, consisting of a couple shape layers or image layers parented to each other. The entire rig is assembled by parenting the limbs to the layers that make up the core of your character. That's essentially your character rig. The limbs of your character are the special sauce that makes character animation in After Effects possible. These limbs have to work in such a way that when you move the controller around your composition, the joints automatically rotate and your limb automatically bends accordingly. To create limbs that function this way, you'll need a special third-party tool. There are four major tools for After Effects in the character animation domain. There is Duik, RubberHose, Deekay, and Limber. There are other tools, but these are the most popular. With different features offered by each tool, it can be challenging to decide which one to use, particularly for beginners. Here's a brief overview of each tool and a recommendation for getting started with character animation. Now, Duik is the most popular tool by far, likely because it's been around the longest and it's free to use, though they do ask for a donation if you can afford it. However, Duik has a steep learning curve, which can be discouraging for those new to character animation in After Effects. In contrast, RubberHose, Deekay Tool, and Limber are all much easier to use by helping you to create functional limbs very easily by just one click of a button. And that allows you to get up and running with your character rigs really quickly. If you're wondering which one I recommend you use, well, if you're just starting out, I recommend that you not commit to any of them yet, because unlike Duik, these other three are not free. However, there is a free version of Limber called Limber Lite, and I think it's a great option if you're just starting out. Limber Lite will give you the full experience of what is involved in rigging and animating characters in After Effects, It just limits the amount of customization you can give your characters. But even then, you still have a lot of flexibility, as I've shown in a previous video. You can actually go pretty far with Limber Lite. I believe that starting with simple characters is actually beneficial for beginners, as it helps you gain a solid understanding of how a rig should be assembled without the added complexity of integrating intricate character designs into that rig. In my experience, character design can often be the most significant obstacle to learning and progressing as a character animator. To successfully incorporate a character design into a rig without breaking it when animating requires knowledge of the entire rigging system. Therefore, I typically recommend starting with straightforward characters and gradually moving on to more complex designs as you become more proficient. I've left a link to Limber Lite in the description below, as well as a link to download a rig that I made for another video for you to tinker with and dissect if that is more your learning style. On another note, I want to point out that these tools don't handle every aspect of a character rig. For example, the hands or foot, except for Duik, which can rig the foot, are usually just layers that are pick-whipped to the controllers of your limbs. To animate your hands, for example, you'll have to either create a custom rig or swap out static layers or use a tool like Handy Hands from AE Scripts. Now, there are some additional tools that cover other important parts of your rig. There is a tool called joysticks and sliders, which is kind of the standard for creating controllers that control your head and the expressions of your character. Now, all this leads me to the big question. Why should you learn character animation in After Effects specifically? With numerous animation programs available, what makes After Effects stand out for character animation? Well, first, familiarity plays a key role. As a motion designer, you're already familiar with After Effects, which makes the learning curve for character rigging and animation less daunting than starting from scratch in a new piece of software. Additionally, investing in another program solely for character animation could set you back hundreds or even thousands of dollars. Why not leverage your existing expertise in After Effects to expand your skill set and open up new career opportunities? Those two factors are what it comes down to for me. But I'm interested to know your thoughts. Why do you want to animate characters in After Effects? Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. That does it for today's video. If you found this video informative, hit that like button so that YouTube knows that more people like you will want to watch this video. If you want more content like this, make sure you're subscribed and hit that bell icon to be notified when the next video comes out. And remember, if you're interested in trying out character animation, I've left a couple links in the description for you to check out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.